America's first space traveler. Alan Sheperd remembers every moment of Mercury 3.
The weather was good, and I remember driving down to the launching pad in a van. And I remember saying to myself, well, I'm not going to see this redstone again. Because I stopped and looked at it, you know, to look back at this beautiful rocket, and thought, well, okay, Buster, let's go and get the job done.
Roger, ready to resume the count, STE?
At this point, no rocket launch is a sure thing.
Okay, Stoney, take it over.
Roger. 5 seconds.
Thousands are at the Cape. 45 million are watching on TV. Astronauts Wally Schirra and Scott Carpenter circle in fighter jets to watch the launch.
We're circling the pad, listening to the count.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Liftoff, and the clock has started. Yes, sir. Reading you loud and clear.
At liftoff, Sheperd's heart rate jumps to 126 beats per minute.
Gee, Kevin, at 14 psi, oxygen is go.
And the rocket sends him 100 miles up, leaving Schirra and Carpenter in the dust.
And Al took off and going straight up, and Wally and I never saw a thing.
No one will catch Sheperd now.
Seven here, fuel is go, 4G.
After pulling 6 Gs to escape Earth,
cut off, tower jettison green.
He marvels at what he left behind.
What a beautiful view. Cloud cover over Florida, 3 to 4 tenths near the eastern coast. Obscures up through Hatteras.
He's only weightless for 5 minutes, but completes a tightly scripted series of tests.
Switching to manual yaw.
He's all business.
Okay, switching to manual pitch.
Re-entry goes without a hitch.
Main chute is raced. Main chute is green. Main chute is coming unraced and it looks good.
America finally makes a splash in the space race.